During our tutorials, we will use the interactive environment called Colab Notebook from Google, which allows us to write and execute our Python code without any setup or configuration. Just use your Google account, access to the website colab.research.google.com, and you can create your first notebook. Welcome back to the second part of the Pandas tutorial. In this video, we will continue exploring Pandas package, and for the first time, we will use a real dataset of the Titanic ship. You can upload this dataset from the website kaggle.com/c/Titanic. Then you can access the data tab and download the trin.csv. This dataset includes the passenger information, like name, age, socioeconomic class, etc., and the dependent variable, which indicates if the passenger was survived or not. One thing that is very important before starting your analysis is to have a look at the data dictionary. As you can see, the variable survived takes a value of 1 if the person was survived, and 0 if not. The variable P class, which is a ticket class, has 3 levels, 1, 2, and 3, etc. Our aim at this stage is not to build a machine learning algorithm, but is to try to benefit from the Pandas method and attribute in order to check if some groups of people were more likely to survive than others. After downloading the CSV file, click on the icon file, then you can upload your CSV data on Colab Notebook. As usual, we need to import pandas as PD and NumPy as NP. Reading the CSV file into pandas data frame is quick and straightforward. To import a CSV dataset, you can use the read_CSV method and put as argument your file path. To get your file path from Colab, right-click on your file and you can copy its path. Let's now have a look at the first 5 rows using the head method. As you can see, the first passenger has an ID 1. He was not survived. He had ticket class 3. His name was Owen Harris. He was male. He was with one of his siblings or spouses, and he was not accompanied by parents or children. And we have also other information like his ticket number and the ticket price. We can also see that the cabinet number is missing and he was embarked from the port S. So the head method is useful for quickly testing if our data frame is well structured. Let's move to the info method. This method is used to print a summary of a data frame. It prints information about the data frame, including the index D type, the column D types, the non-null values, and the memory usage. We can see that we have 890 observations and 12 columns. We can also see that the variables age, cabin, and embarked have missing data. Let's now use the describe method on our numerical data. So for the passenger ID, nothing special. It's just an index starting from 1 to 891. For our target variable survived, it takes 2 values, 0 and 1. And we can see that the mean, which indicates the percentage of the survived passengers, is about 38%. P class is a class ticket. It has 3 levels, 1, 2, and 3. We can see that the average age of the passengers is about 30 years. The SIB-SP, which is the number of siblings and spouses, is between 0 and 8. The PARSH, which is the number of parents and children, is between 0 and 6. And we can also see that 75% of the ticket price are less than 31. Let's print out the number of missing data per column. As we did in the previous tutorial, we use isNull method, which returns a data frame of Boolean, and we add the sum method. As we have noticed before, 3 variables have missing data: age, cabin, and embark. There are several techniques for handling the missing data. The imputation, which is the process of replacing the missing data with substitute value, like the mean, the median, maximum, etc. And we will apply this this technique for the age variable. The second technique is to drop the entire column, specifically if there is more than 80% missing data, like the cabin variable, which has 687 missing data. The third technique is to drop only the rows or the observations with missing data. For instance, we can drop the two rows where the embarked values are missing. In order to do the imputation with the variable age, we use the fillNA method and we specify as argument the median of the column age. Note that the median is robust, as it's not affected by outliers. If you want to modify your data in place, do not forget to set the parameter in place to true, which means it will return nothing and the data frame is now updated. By using the drop method, we can remove the column cabin and also two other columns which are useless for our analysis. And finally, we can use dropNA method to remove only the rows where the two embarked values are missing. Now, if we print out the number of missing data per column, we can see that there is no missing data. By using the info method, we can also observe that all the values are non-nulls. Let's now print out some interesting percentages. The percentage of the survived passengers can be easily calculated by summing the column survived and divide it by the length of our data frame DF. The percentage of the female can be calculated by summing the column sex when it's equal to the value female and divide it by the length of DF. The percentage of the male can be calculated by summing the column sex when it's equal to the value male and divided by the length of DF. An easy way to calculate the percentage of the female and male is to use the value underscore counts method and divide it by the length of the DF. Let's now calculate the percentage of the female survived. First, we need to create a data frame which contains only the females and then select the variable survived. Then, by summing the female data frame and divide the result by its length, we get the percentage of the female survived. The result is that 74% of females were survived. We can do the same operations to get the percentage of the males survived, and this time the percentage is about 19%, which is very low compared to the females. So our first conclusion is that the females is more likely to survive than males. In pandas, you can do all the previous operations in one line using group by method. Group by splits the data into different groups depending on a variable of your choice. For example, we select first the two variables sex and survived and we group by the variable sex. Then we apply the mean function. As you can see, we get the same values as before. 74% of females were survived and 19% of males were survived. There is still a lot to learn about pandas, so I propose to continue exploring our Titanic dataset in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot for watching and see you soon.